This is Jigoro Kano, the founder of Kodokan Judo. Professor Kano learned the traditional Japanese martial art jujitsu and transformed it into something new, employing the objectives and methodology appropriate to a new era. In 1882, he named it Kodokan Judo. Judo, which Professor Kano promoted with all his might for half a century, gradually became more and more popular around the world and has now achieved recognition as an Olympic event. It's now practiced in 178 countries throughout the world. Judo techniques can be divided into three categories. They are nage-waza, throwing techniques, katame-waza, grappling techniques, and atemi-waza, striking techniques. Atemi-waza, however, are not used in judo matches. Nage-waza, or throwing techniques, can be divided into tachi-waza, standing techniques, and stemi-waza, sacrificing techniques. There are 66 techniques in all, and they're classified as shown here. Let's look at the basics of each technique and how it's applied, focusing on the differences between techniques that may appear similar with examples from actual competitions. In seoi nage, you grasp one side of your opponent's collar and put your elbow underneath his arm as you lift and throw him over your shoulder. Here, you grasp your opponent's sleeve as well as one side of his collar. This seoi nage was applied after stepping out wide to the side. It's a variation of seoi nage and not a tai otoshi. This seoi nage was applied just with an upward lift of the right hand. He did not grasp his opponent's sleeve. Here he grasped one side of his opponent's collar. Seoi nage executed from a low position. Ippon seoi nage. In Ippon seoi nage, you hold and control one of your opponent's arms as you lift and throw him over your shoulder. When applying an Ippon Seoi Nage, you can also step out wide to the side of your opponent's right foot. An Ippon Seoi Nage applied as if wrapping your opponent's body around you. An Ippon Seoi Nage applied with your arm turned. Let's look at some examples of Ippon Seoi Nage in competition.
Seoi otoshi. Seoi Otoshi is a throwing technique where you take your opponent on your back and pull him straight down. As you throw, you can do so either with one knee or both knees on the floor. Seoi Otoshi, moving from an Ippon Seoi Nage position. In Seoi Nage, you throw your opponent by lifting him over, but in Seoi Otoshi, you throw him by pulling him down over you. Seoi Otoshi on both knees. Whether it's Seoi Nage or Seoi Otoshi is decided by whether your opponent was lifted or pulled over. This is Seoi Nage with both knees on the floor. We judge so because after going down on both knees, the throw was made by raising the hip and hoisting the opponent's frame. Tai Otoshi. There are various ways of executing Tai Otoshi depending on the situation. This is Tai Otoshi executed by drawing the opponent out. This is a tailing Tai Otoshi, executed the moment the opponent moves his leg back. In this Tai Otoshi, the opponent has been drawn out sideways. There are cases where Tai Otoshi is executed by grabbing one side of the collar. Double motion Tai Otoshi. It was executed first of all by lightly kicking the inside of the opponent's foot to make him lose balance. In another instance, you might cross your opponent's arms when executing the throw. By twisting your opponent's arms, his body goes off balance and his resistance is stopped.
Let's look at some examples of Tai Otoshi in competition. This Tai Otoshi started out as an Uchimata.
Kataguruma. Kataguruma is a technique in which you haul your opponent up above you as you throw. As you can see, the throw is generally made by throwing your opponent down toward the tip of your foot. In kataguruma, the throw can be made in any number of directions after you raise your opponent up. In this case, the opponent is thrown directly in front. It appears that this kind of throw was often used in the early days of modern judo. In this kataguruma, the body of the opponent is raised up high, and the throw is then made by bending backwards. The direction of the throws may differ, but these are all considered kataguruma, and the effect of the throw is recognized. Here you enter low on one knee, raise your opponent up and throw him down. Toshi. The turi, or active partner, pulls the uke, or passive partner, forward, goes down on one knee, and pulls him down in front. The aim of practicing kata, or form, is to make students realize the principle behind the technique. In ukiyotoshi, you sometimes step in the moment your opponent steps forward with his left foot, then execute your throw by pulling him off balance to one side of you. When your right hand is grasping the middle of the sleeve like this, you can force him to go off balance by pushing up on his elbow. Have another look. Dodging your opponent's osotogari by pulling back your leg, turn aside and then throw. This is also ukiyotoshi. Sumiyotoshi. Sumiyotoshi is a throwing technique in which you shake your opponent off balance into the rear corner, then throw him by thrusting him down. Using your right hand, you pull up your opponent by grasping his left collar. You make your opponent lose balance by causing him to raise his left foot and shift his weight to his right heel. In another instance, you shift your grip from his left collar to the middle of his sleeve. You then push his elbow up to make him lose balance. Sumiyotoshi and ukiyotoshi make up a pair. Let's now look at the difference between sumiyotoshi and ukiyotoshi. In sumiyotoshi, you push and throw your opponent down to the rear. In ukiyotoshi, you pull and throw your opponent down to the front. The direction of off-balancing and throwing your opponent differs. Sumiyotoshi was one of the favorite techniques of Kyuzo Mifune, the 10th Dan. Pay close attention to the principle of the technique, where you force your opponent's left foot to come forward and throw him down in a backward direction. Sukui Nage. tournament, the technique of placing a hand underneath your opponent's thigh and lifting him up is often used. When your opponent tries a harai-goshi, you should pull your foot back to open yourself up for an attack, then put your hand in from behind your opponent to lift him up and throw him down. Similarly, when your opponent comes at you with an osotogari, then you should again put your hand in from behind and throw. Again, when he attempts an uchimata, you can evade his motion, then putting your hand in from behind, transform it into a sukui-nage. On occasion, you may throw using your hips as you lift your opponent. This time, the opponent is lifted by putting a hand in from the front. When your opponent tries osotogari, pull your foot back, then as you do so, put your hand in from the front and lift him up.
A dynamic sukui-nage. It looks like a morotegari, but since she merely lifted and dropped her opponent with both hands, it's a sukui-nage. A morotegari is when you reap your opponent's legs towards you with both hands and throw him directly to the rear.
Obi otoshi. Obi otoshi can be considered a kind of sukui-nage. It is one of the techniques of jujutsu, the traditional martial art. Grasp the front part of your opponent's belt. Push him directly back to cause him to lose balance, lift him from the side, and throw him down towards the rear. The principle of obi-otoshi is very much like that of sukui-nage. Obi-otoshi is hardly ever used in modern tournaments, but is one of the techniques used in free exercises of Kodokan Judo. Morote-gari. Morote-gari is often used in a competition. There are different ways of starting morote-gari. In this case, you catch your opponent the moment you come to grapple with him. This is morote-gari where you first pull your opponent forward. In this case, seoi-nage turns into a morote-gari. When you attempt seoi-nage, your opponent will react by bending backwards. Morote-gari is then performed without a pause. In following on from a seoi-nage, you sometimes make one complete turn, as you can see here.
This is a morote-gari.
Kuchiki-daoshi. Kuchiki-daoshi is a technique in which you take your opponent's leg and push him down backwards. It's often used in a tournament. You push your opponent down by taking hold of his leg, but sometimes it's executed from the inside as well as from the outside. This is a follow-on technique starting from kataguruma. A kataguruma is attempted, but as your opponent defends himself by shifting his weight backwards, the throw is made by grasping his leg from inside. This time we start with the opponent's osotogari. When the opponent attacks with osotogari, defend yourself by opening up, turning sideways. As you do so, catch him from inside his legs to make him fall. Here you down your opponent by catching his leg from outside. When you perform kochigari, your opponent counters by raising the foot that's been swept from the side. Grasp his leg from outside at that moment to make him fall. This time, continuing from ochigari. The moment your opponent raises his foot to counter the move, you catch his leg from outside to drop him.
A dazzling kuchiki daoshi executed with speed. This kuchiki daoshi started out as an uchimata.
Kibis gaeshi. Kibis gaeshi is a technique in which you fell your opponent by taking hold of his heel. There are two ways of performing kibis gaeshi. Either by grasping the inside of your opponent's heel, or by grasping the outside. First make seoi nage, then turn once to face your opponent to follow on to kibis gaeshi. First, grasping your opponent's heel from outside. Catch your opponent's heel from outside as he tries to withdraw, then cut him down by pushing with your left hand. In the following case, too, you grasp the heel from outside. From kochigari, you make your opponent fall by taking the heel of the raised foot from outside. Let's compare techniques. In kuchiki daoshi, you push your opponent down by putting your hand on his leg. In kibis gaeshi, you grasp your opponent's heel and cut him right down on the spot.
Reap your opponent's heel with one hand and throw her.
Kochigaeshi. In Kochigaeshi, you dodge your opponent's Kochigari, then drop him by twisting to either right or left. When your opponent attacks with a Kochigari, you evade by raising the foot that's been struck, then make a throw by twisting him to the left. This time, twisting to the right. Look closely at how you evade the attack and how you make the twist. This is Daiashi Harai, brushing off the starting move. When the Kochigari of your opponent is brushed off like this, it'll be called Daiashi Harai. This is Hizaguruma. The opponent's Kochigari changes into a Hizaguruma. Kochigaeshi is classified as a hand technique, not a foot technique.
Although she didn't twist her body, it's a Kochigaeshi.
Uchimata Sukashi. When your opponent attacks with Uchimata, you move your right foot back, turn and twist. The opponent, losing his target, will only hit empty air and fall, drawing a large arc as he does so. Occasionally, you may raise one of your feet up high to dodge the attack. This also is an application of Uchimata Sukashi.
In Uchimata Sukashi, you use your opponent's momentum to throw him forward. It's a tewaza or hand technique.
Yama Arashi. Shiro Saigo, the sixth Dan, is considered to be the model of the hero of the novel Sanshiro Sugata. Though small in stature, his fierce performance won him the praise. There were no Yama Arashi to speak of before or after Saigo. Yama Arashi is performed by grasping your opponent's collar and sleeve on the same side, lifting him up as in Harai Goshi, then dropping him using the hip. With your right hand placed inside the collar of your opponent, with the thumb inside, push against his right chest. Push your opponent down. Then, just as he tries to raise himself, jump in and throw him. The foot movement is similar to that of Harai Goshi. Your toes should be put close to your opponent's ankle as you brush it upwards. Simultaneously, lift with the right hand while brushing upwards with the right foot, then throw in a large motion upwards.
Obitori gaeshi. Obitorigaeshi is a technique by which you reach over your opponent's shoulder to grasp his belt, using your other hand to take hold of his trousers, pressing your knee against his groin, and leaning backwards to throw him. It's a tewaza. You can also lean back to throw your opponent without pressing your knee against his groin.
Oh, in ogoshi, you pull your opponent forward with your arm around his waist, then throw on your waist. Move in with your hip low. Make your throw only after your opponent's hip is sufficiently close. With your left hand, pull your opponent out off balance, forward to your left. Bring his waist sufficiently close to place him on your hips. Then, with both elbows outstretched, pull him straight up to throw. With your left hand under your opponent's side, as you come to grapple, pull his waist close and perform ogoshi.
And now let's look at the technique ogoshi.
Ukigoshi. In ukigoshi, you draw your opponent's waist in close using one of your arms, then throw using the twisting motion of your waist. In the practice form, the throw is made as your opponent attacks, as if to strike. In ukigoshi, you throw in a twisting motion after bending back fully, using your left hip as the fulcrum. Your shoulder is placed deep under your opponent's arm, and your arm secures his waist positioned parallel to his belt. Look once again at how you bend your back, how your shoulder should be positioned, and how your waist is twisted. This is a rare film showing Professor Kano explaining his favorite technique, ukigoshi, before the practice hall of Tokyo Higher Normal School in the early part of the century. Surigoshi. In tsurigoshi, you grasp your opponent's belt from behind, then bringing him in close, lift and throw on your hip. You must defend against your opponent's tsurikomigoshi while you grasp his belt from under his arm as you throw. In this form of tsurigoshi, you grasp your opponent's belt over his shoulder. Pulling your opponent forward, you grasp his belt over his shoulder and throw using tsurigoshi. Throwing as you grasp the front part of your opponent's belt is also an application of the tsurigoshi technique. It's called a tsurigoshi only when the belt is grasped in making the throw. Tsurikomigoshi. This is the kata form of tsurikomigoshi. The moment your opponent protects himself by bending backwards, lower your hips and making the fulcrum of your throw, pull him down with both your arms. In randori, you pull your opponent up with both arms and throw him on your hips when moving either forwards or backwards. Take firm hold of the rear of your opponent's jacket when he's bent forward in a defensive posture to throw, pulling him up. This is also tsurikomigoshi.
ですね。音がしますね。音がするぐらい。あ、入った。日本。袖釣り込み腰。
You then have a choice of either taking hold of his sleeve opening like this, or taking hold of the elbow section of his sleeve. When grasping the sleeve opening, you sometimes do so by pushing your opponent's hand away. The throw is made when he comes back with the same hand to grasp your jacket.
Let's look at some variations of Sode Tsuri Komigoshi. You can also throw your opponent without using a left hikite, lifting and pulling with just the right hand.
Koshi guruma. In koshi guruma, you grasp your opponent by the neck and throw in a twisting motion with him on your hips. Control your opponent by holding his neck. Place your waist deep under him and push to the side. Koshi guruma must be executed by holding your opponent's neck. Harai goshi. In randori, you seldom put your hand in as shown here. Here, the technique is performed by following the motion of your opponent who withdraws. Another chance for using harai goshi presents itself when you pull your opponent out sideways as shown here.
Let's look at some examples of harai goshi.
hane goshi. Hane goshi is a technique of throwing your opponent by bouncing him up using the movement of your hip and foot. Hane goshi executed in pursuit. It's made the moment your opponent retreats and brings his left foot down. The leg to be used in bouncing your opponent up should be bent a little. You bounce him up around the lower part of his knee. The technique may be used after guiding your opponent sideways. Let's look at the difference between hanegoshi and haraigoshi. In hanegoshi, you bounce your opponent up with your leg bent. In haraigoshi, your leg is straight as you bounce your opponent up. Uchimata looks similar to hanegoshi, except you place your leg in between your opponent's legs and bounce him up. Utsurigoshi. Utsurigoshi is a kind of technique used when your opponent attacks with koshiwaza, to raise him up and throw him on your hips. This is an utsurigoshi technique which originates from the opponent's hanegoshi. This is utsurigoshi which started out as an uchimata by the opponent. You completely raise your opponent up by the waist and opening outwards, throw after moving him over on your hips. Ushirogoshi. This is the throw to use when your opponent attacks with koshiwaza. You lift your opponent up and throw him down in front of you. This ushirogoshi has developed from the opponent's hanegoshi. Ushirogoshi executed just as your opponent tries to defend himself by curling his feet around yours. When changing into ushirogoshi, your opponent may try defending himself by attacking your foot, as in ouchigari. You then lift up the foot that's been attacked, hoist him up, then throw him down. This is in case your opponent defends himself using something like kouchigari. If your opponent defends himself by using kouchigari from inside, lift your foot that's been attacked, hoist him up, and throw him down. When your opponent attacks with osotogari, push his waist up with your leg as you throw him down. Izaguruma. Izaguruma is a technique of supporting your opponent's knee with your foot as you throw. As your opponent tries to step forward, place the sole of your foot on his knee. Your opponent will turn and fall in a twisting motion. Izaguruma performed after transferring your right hand from his left lapel to mid-sleeve. Another method, where your opponent's knee is bent. Step forward. Execute the technique as if trying to bend your opponent's knee. He then falls in a twisting motion. Sasae tsurikomi ashi. Sasae tsurikomi ashi is executed by putting the sole of your foot on your opponent's ankle and throwing with that as the fulcrum. This is when your opponent has stepped forward. This is when you first lightly slap the inside of your opponent's left foot before executing the technique. The aim of this is to destroy your opponent's balance toward the tip of his right foot as you slap his foot from inside. Sasae tsurikomi ashi made to look like o sotogari. When o sotogari is executed, your opponent defends by moving his weight forward in reaction. Turn your body at that moment, support with your foot as you throw. Harai tsurikomi ashi. In harai tsurikomi ashi, you can throw your opponent by a sweeping blow to the rear of his foot. Here, the right foot of the opponent is swept away as he tries to retreat, and then he's thrown. You slap at the inside of the foot of your opponent as he tries to retreat to destroy his balance towards the tip of his right foot, then sweep him off his feet. Let's compare these two techniques. In Sasae tsurikomi ashi, you support your opponent's foot as you throw. In harai tsurikomi ashi, you slap at your opponent's feet as you make your throw. Sasae and harai are similar in form, but are different in that one has the sasaeru, or supporting motion, whereas the other has the harai ageru, or sweeping motion.
Note how it differs from Sasae tsurikomi ashi. You need to sweep him forward.
Teya shiharai. In Teya shiharai, you sweep away one of your opponent's feet that's moved forward. When your opponent steps forward with his right foot, you open up with your right and sweep using your left foot. Here you sweep the retreating right foot of the opponent who's trying to move back. Here you lead your opponent around and sweep his right foot as he steps forward.
There are various ways to apply Deyashi Harai. Here you sweep your opponent's right foot from under him just as his weight is shifting to his right foot. This is a Deyashi Harai applied to counter your opponent's Kouchi-gari.
Okuriyashi harai. Okuriyashi harai is a technique where you sweep away both of your opponent's feet as you throw him. You lead your opponent around and sweep away both his feet. In Okuriyashi harai, you sweep away both your opponent's feet as they're together. Okuriyashi harai performed in two steps. You step in and sweep away the retreating foot of your opponent. Let's compare similar techniques. In Okuriyashi harai, you sweep away both your opponent's feet together. In Deyashi harai, you sweep away your opponent's foot as he steps forward. In harai tsurikomiyashi, you sweep away your opponent's foot as it retreats towards the far corner. We decide the technique used according to these criteria. Tsubame gaeshi. Tsubame gaeshi is a technique of throwing your opponent by reversing his foot sweep into your own. Shift directly to your right or left. If your opponent attacks with deyashi harai or okuriyashi harai, you dodge it and turn it into tsubame gaeshi. Even when moving back, you can also do likewise. Kosotogari. Changing your opponent's taiotoshi into kosotogari. Dodging your opponent's taiotoshi, make him off balance, standing on both his heels. Then cut him down in the direction of his toes using the back of your feet. Your foot will be placed on roughly the same line as your opponent's. When you're clipping, you should do so from your opponent's heels in the direction of his toes, as if rubbing the surface of the mat. Your opponent should fall suddenly on the spot. Kosoto gake. Kosoto gake is a technique of throwing your opponent in a kind of pulling up motion. Sometimes the sole of the foot, at other times the leg is used for clipping. As the opponent withdraws his left foot, shifting his weight onto his other foot, you make him fall, hooking with your leg. You first try an uchimata. Then the moment your opponent tries to defend himself, leaning backward, you turn it into kosotogake. Here you take hold of the rear collar to bring your opponent in close, push him back to go off balance, then hook and make him fall. Now let's see the differences between similar techniques. In kosotogari, you step in close to the side of your opponent, make him lose balance on his heel and clip him down. In deashiharai, the moment your opponent's foot is about to touch the mat, or when his foot is about to be lifted off the mat, you sweep his foot away to make him fall. In kosotogake, you make your opponent lose his balance by making him stand on his heels as you face him directly. Clip as if to pull your opponent up and backwards as you throw him. Sotogari. Pull the right leg of your opponent out, then clip him down the moment it touches the mat. Pull his left leg out and cut down on his right leg. Osotogari from a harai tsurikomiashi. As your opponent advances to defend himself, cut down on his right leg. Here you push your opponent's elbow to make him lose balance and cut him down to the rear. Thank you.
soto otoshi. In o soto otoshi, you press your leg against your opponent's thigh from behind to make him fall on his back. An o soto otoshi applied while holding your opponent's neck. With o soto otoshi, you press your leg down against your opponent's thigh from behind to make him fall backwards.
Soto guruma. In osoto guruma, you begin your throw as in osoto gari, but cut both your opponent's legs as you twist him down. Sometimes it's done in two movements. In a variation of this, you step behind both your opponent's legs with your right leg and make him fall, as in tai otoshi. O soto gaeshi. As your opponent steps in trying to execute o soto gari, you instead cut him down at that moment using the same throw. Here, the opponent's o soto gari is returned after a short delay. As you defend yourself against your opponent's o soto gari by pulling back your right foot, you counter with an o soto gari. As you defend against your opponent's o soto gari by pulling back your left foot, you counter as if in o soto gaeshi. Another example where an opportunity to counter came still later. Guruma. Oguruma is a technique where you make your throw by turning your opponent around your leg as an axis. Placing your leg near the lower abdomen of your opponent to use as an axis, you turn him around and throw. Oguruma was one of the favorite techniques of the 10th Dan, Kyuzo Mifune. He's captured the moment his opponent tries to step forward on his right foot. Ashiguruma. In ashiguruma, you place your foot on your opponent's knee and throw with that as an axis. It's the same principle as hizaguruma. Here, an osotogari is followed by ashiguruma. First, you execute osotogari. When your opponent responds by withdrawing his left foot, you follow with ashiguruma. Mata. Here you jump in to make your throw the moment your opponent withdraws his foot and touches the mat. Pull your opponent forward to make him assume jigotai, or a self-defense position. Then jump in and apply uchimata just as he raises himself. This is a method generally known as ken-ken uchimata. You sweep with your left leg to destroy your opponent's balance and throw. First, you make a move, as in performing ouchigari. Then it's transformed into uchimata. In this situation, the objective is to cause your opponent to open up his legs and lean forward off balance. If your opponent defends himself by going down on one knee, he's still judged to be standing, and the uchimata is recognized.
Let's look at some examples of uchimata.
Uchimata gaishi. In uchimata gaishi, when your opponent attacks with uchimata, you counter by cutting back on his pivotal foot. Ouchigari. Pull your opponent's foot forward, then just as he tries to put his weight on that foot, clip his foot and make him fall. Here the opponent is pulled in close, then clipped the moment he tries to rise up. Here, when the opponent tries to get away by raising his foot, he's pushed forward and cut down off balance. Here, his leg is grabbed as you clip. Ochigaeshi. Ochigaeshi is a technique of countering your opponent's ochigari with an ochigari of your own. There are two ways of countering. One is to clip the foot that's clipping you, and the other is to clip your opponent's pivotal foot. Here, the opponent's foot is clipped back as he tries to clip you. Here you counter by clipping both your opponent's attacking foot as well as his pivotal foot at the same time. Dodge your opponent's ochigari and counter with a twisting motion. This is also ochigaeshi. Use your opponent's force to return the attack by twisting to the right. First, dodging your opponent's ochigari, then throwing and twisting to your left. Ochigari. In Kochigari, you pull your opponent's foot forward, then you clip just as his foot comes down on the mat. In this instance, you cut down on the retreating foot of your opponent. Here, Kochigari is performed by pulling the opponent off sideways. And here, you cause your opponent to open his feet wide and clip after subduing his defense.
This is a Kochigari. Kochigari applied with good timing. He countered his opponent's uranage with a kochigari. Japan's Okada has a distinctive style of kouchigari, using his heel to reap his opponent's foot.
Hane goshigaeshi. There are two ways of performing hane goshigaeshi. One is a leg technique, whereby you reap the pivotal foot of your opponent. And another is a hip technique, of pushing up with the hip and twisting before countering. At times, you hold the opponent's waist and reap your opponent's pivotal foot. With your hip, you bounce your opponent up in a large motion, then throw, twisting with both hands. When bouncing your opponent with your hip, you may at times simultaneously sweep upwards using your leg. Harai goshigaeshi. In harai goshigaeshi, you counter by reaping your opponent's pivotal foot for executing harai goshi. Just as your opponent attacks with harai goshi, you counter by extending your hips, then reap his pivotal foot to make him fall. The technique you use in countering, holding your opponent's hips, is also harai goshigaeshi. Here the opponent's hips are being held, but as the counter action is reaping his pivotal foot, it's not ushirogoshi. Ushirogoshi is a technique where you raise your opponent up, holding him by the hip and letting him fall. Tomoe nage. In tomoe nage, you drop backwards while putting a foot on your opponent's lower abdomen and throw him back over your head. Here, the technique is applied just as soon as your opponent steps forward and tries to put his weight on his foot. Here, the opponent is pulled out forward at a slight angle as the technique is applied. This is the way you apply the technique when your opponent is in a right-handed position, making him go off balance on his toes and making him fall to his right as you throw. Here, the throw is made over your head, when your opponent is in the right-handed position. Uranage. The principle behind this form is to use the force of your opponent as you dodge his striking motion and to throw him, lifting him up on your hip as you sacrifice yourself by falling backward. Here, the opponent's hanegoshi is transformed into an uranage. As the opponent attacks with a hanegoshi, hold his hips and bring him close and throw him directly behind over your shoulder. Another way is to hold and raise your opponent up from the front, then leaning back, throw by sacrificing yourself. Sumigaeshi. You start with both sides grappling in a defensive position. The technique was already in existence in Koryu, one of the older schools of Jiu-Jitsu, and the exact same form has been handed down. In the present-day Dandori, we do not start directly from such a position. In Sumigaeshi, you fall backwards in a self-sacrificing movement. Place the instep of your right foot in the crook of his left knee and lift him up over your head. You pull your opponent forward, grasping his rear collar to execute sumigaeshi. Here it's done by grasping your opponent's rear collar or his back and starts with uchimata. Here it's a quick turn around from the uchimata position, followed on with sumigaeshi. Komigaeshi. In a dandori situation, the throw is often made by pulling your opponent in close, holding his belt at the rear, then by throwing him, falling down in a self-sacrificing motion. The place where your foot is applied varies. There's no set place. This is the method of throwing by falling to your side. In this case, it becomes yokostemiwaza. You pull your opponent's belt at the rear close and throw by falling sideways in a self-sacrificing motion. Tawara Gaeshi. In Tawara Gaeshi, you hold your opponent from above to pull him close, then throw as you fall face up in a self-sacrificing motion. In this situation, your opponent defends himself by leaning forward. This Tawara Gaeshi follows upon the opponent's Morote Gari. When your opponent jumps in close to execute Morote Gari, you pull your feet back, drop your hip low to defend yourself, then counter. Uki-waza. In uki-waza, you step sideways on one foot, sacrificing your balance, and throw your opponent in the direction of your foot. Around 1883, when the nage no kata form of the throw was established, the technique was performed starting with grappling in the self-defense posture. This is uki-waza, performed by pulling the opponent forward. This uki-waza is performed by stepping in with your right foot when your opponent withdraws his left foot. At times, you might assume an oblique defensive posture after pulling your opponent forward by grasping his rear collar and a sleeve and throw from a self-sacrificing posture. This is a technique of following on from kataguruma to uki-waza. In this technique, as you're sacrificing yourself in making the throw, it is not kataguruma. Yoko Otoshi. In Yoko Otoshi, you step to one side and throw your opponent directly to one side in a sacrificing motion. Observe the off-balancing to the side and sacrificing motion. Pull your opponent to one side, make him go off-balance, then throw, sacrificing yourself. As you can see, in a yoko otoshi, off-balancing and throwing are done to the side. Tani otoshi. In Tani Otoshi, you step behind both legs of your opponent in a sacrificing motion, then throw him down directly behind. If you can push his elbow up, it becomes even more easy to make him go off balance and fall backwards. Here, kuchiki daoshi is transformed into tani otoshi. On occasions when kuchiki daoshi cannot be executed, you might step in, throwing in a self-sacrificing motion. This also is a kind of tani otoshi. Here you hold your opponent's right arm under your left arm. You perform tani otoshi, sacrificing yourself. Let's look at these three similar techniques. In uki-waza, you make your opponent lose his balance forward. He's thrown in that direction. In yoko otoshi, you make your opponent lose his balance to the side. He's thrown in that direction. In tani otoshi, you make your opponent lose his balance backward, and he's thrown in that direction. Yoko Watare. In Yoko Watare, you step in with both of your feet next to your opponent's feet, then throw him over your body, sacrificing yourself. The moment your opponent's feet are together, sacrifice yourself and throw him above your body. Here, the opponent's ogoshi is transformed into a yoko watare. As soon as your opponent attacks with ogoshi, you open sideways and turn it into a yoko watare. Transforming your opponent's deashi harai. When your opponent attacks with deashi harai, step up close and sacrificing yourself, throw sideways with a yoko wakare. Yoko wakare can also be performed as mastemi waza on the floor. Yoko gake. When practicing the kata, destroy your opponent's balance in about 2.5 steps, then throw, sacrificing yourself. In this technique, it's important to make your opponent go off balance till he's supported only by his toes. You sweep, thrusting powerfully with your sole just underneath your opponent's ankle from the front, then sacrificing yourself, throw him parallel to your body. Because yokogake is extremely difficult to set up, it's hardly ever used in dandori. You sometimes see it used in conjunction with sasae tsurikomiyashi in practice. The opponent falls after being thrown in a large whirl. This too is an application of yokogake. Daki wakare. In fighting on the mat, if your opponent does not get up, you can raise and hold him up from the side, then twisting, throw over your body. It appears that in the early days of judo, the effect of this technique was allowed even if you were on a mat. However, under the present system of judging, the effect of the throw is no longer recognized. Here, standing fight becomes dakiwakare. When your opponent attacks with an uchimata, you might try catching him from the rear to apply another technique. Then, when he lets down both of his hands and escapes, you can apply dakiwakare. The effect of the technique is recognized in this case. Yokoguruma. If you try throwing your opponent with an uranage as he comes at you, he defends himself by twisting. Put your right foot between both his feet at that moment and throw, sacrificing yourself. Here, the opponent's hanegoshi is turned into this technique. Here's the way to apply it, following on from taneotoshi. The moment your opponent bends forward to defend himself against taneotoshi, then you follow with this. Soto makikomi. In soto makikomi, hold your opponent's arm under your arm. Step in close with your hips, then turning, throw him over your body in a wrapping motion. Place your hip close to the opponent to use as an axis in the throw. This is the basic principle of soto makikomi. Placing your hip next to your opponent, but not so deep, and throwing him. This is also soto makikomi. Here's soto makikomi, where you first step in with your feet. You can also step sideways in a large motion outside your opponent's right foot to wrap him around. Uchimakikomi. Uchimakikomi is similar to Ippon Seoi Nage. Grasp your opponent by the arm and twist sideways to wrap him around you. Use your hip as an axis. Twist and throw in a wrapping motion. This is the basis of Uchimakikomi. Here's Uchimakikomi, where you step out on your right foot to set it up. Here's Uchimakikomi after you've made your opponent retreat. Here you follow on from Ippon Seoi Nage. The moment your opponent defends himself by turning away, you grasp his neck with an arm and pull, wrapping him around you. We distinguish between Seoi Nage and Uchimakikomi by whether you carried your opponent on your shoulder or simply wrapped him around you as you controlled his arm. Hane makikomi. In hane makikomi, you throw in a wrapping motion as you lift your opponent up with hane goshi. There are two methods of executing this throw. The first is to lift up your opponent and wrap him around you as you grasp him by the arm. The second method is to lift your opponent up with hanegoshi, then wrap him around you. There's a difference in the timing of when you take hold of your opponent's arm. In this case, the opponent's collar has simply been grasped, and he's not been wrapped around. This is hanegoshi, not hanemakikomi. Harai makikomi. In harai makikomi, you lift your opponent up using harai goshi, then throw, wrapping him around you. There are two ways to throw. In the first method, lift up your opponent and wrap him around you as you grasp him by the arm like this. Another method is to lift your opponent up with harai goshi, then place his arm under yours to wrap him around you. There's a difference in the timing of when you grasp your opponent's arm. Again, in this case, the opponent's collar has simply been grasped and he's not been wrapped around. This is harai goshi, not harai makikomi.
And now for a spectacular harai makikomi. Makikomi. Kouchi makikomi involves grabbing your opponent's legs from the inside and falling to the side to bring him down. Since you bring him down with a sacrificing movement, it's a yokostemi waza. Rolling over after grabbing your opponent's legs is a variation of kouchi makikomi. Let's look at some examples of kouchi makikomi in competition.
Uchimata makikomi. In uchimata makikomi, you lift your opponent up using uchimata. Then throw, wrapping him around you. There are two ways to make the throw. The first is to lift up your opponent and wrap him around you as you grasp him by the arm. The second method is to lift your opponent up with uchimata, then wrap him around you and throw. Please observe carefully the timing of grasping the opponent's arm under yours. Soto makikomi. All soto makikomi starts with one of the all soto gari family of techniques, followed by either an outer or inner wrap-around throw. In the first case, following your opponent's defense of an all soto gari, you throw by wrapping them around you in an outward direction. From an osoto gari, you lean on your opponent and throw him, wrapping him outwards. The final technique used is soto makikomi, but as it follows osoto gari, the throw is called osoto makikomi.
Prohibited techniques. Kani basami is a technique in which you sandwich your opponent's body between both feet and throw him in a sacrificing movement.
Yakuni Kondo, how are you going to これはどうしよう。おっと、カニバサミヒット。
カニバサミ is a prohibited technique and if applied will result in a 反則負け。カワズ掛け。Since the technique involves falling together with your opponent, it's often dangerous and is therefore prohibited in a tournament. Quite often, it's difficult to judge the name of the nage-waza being applied. With more research and development, new techniques may well emerge. However, the name will be chosen from one of the 66 throws, depending on the principle behind the technique used. We hope this video will help you understand the classifications and names of the nage-waza techniques, as well as the basic principles of judo.Breaking the balance of one's opponent to apply a technique and using his momentum to throw him.